Good morning. Good morning. Welcome all of you today on this wintry day. And we celebrate today the baptism of our Lord and the first Sunday in Epiphany. Quick announcements. First of all, annual reports are available at the Welcome Center, so you can pick those up at your leisure. Second of all, next Sunday between services, there will be a forum on our mission and ministry plan for 2020. So you can come and be part of that and hear about the financial plans for the coming year. And then the annual meeting will be the following Sunday, the 26th, at noon. So those three things coming up. Some thank yous this morning. First of all, to our shoveling teams who keep our walkways clean and our steps sort of dry. And also thank you to our sacristans and operating folks and our confirmands who all came together in the icy morning of yesterday to take down the Christmas decorations and to prepare us for the Epiphany season. So we're grateful for what? Whoa! Woo! Go confirmation. Go confirmation. By the way, the confirmants now have, and the youth now have, a popcorn machine, just so you know. So there will be popcorn available at upcoming events, I believe.
For our Lenten drive-in series.
For our Lenten drive-in series, absolutely. So mark that on your calendar, beginning the first Wednesday in March, following Ash Wednesday, the 26th of February. So we'll begin today with a thanks, since it is the baptism of our Lord, we begin today with thanksgiving for baptism, and we will also be sprinkling you to remind you today of your baptism as well when you receive those drops of water as they come forth from us to you. So please stand.
Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of all life. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams, for clouds and rain, for dew and snow. Your waters are below us, around us, above us. Our life is born in you. Praise to you for your saving waters. Noah and the animals survived the flood. Hagar discovers your well. The Israelites escape through the sea, and they drink from your gushing rock. Naaman washes his leprosy away, and the Samaritan woman will never be thirsty again. At this font, holy God, we pray. Praise to you for the water of baptism, and for your word that saves us in this water. Breathe your spirit into all who are gathered here and into all creation. Illumine our days, enliven our bones, dry our tears, wash away the sin within us, and drown the evil around us. Satisfy our thirst with your living water through Jesus Christ, now and forever. Amen.
As we sing,
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, our Father, at the baptism of Jesus, you proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit. Make all who are baptized into Christ faithful to their calling to be your daughters and sons, and empower us all with your Spirit through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. We have a children's message. We're going to meet at the baptismal font. Imagine that. That's a good place, isn't it? Yes. There's a lot of water going on today. Hi, guys. Come on up, belly up right on up to the baptismal font. Can you see in there? It's hard to see in there, isn't it? If you want, you can take your hand and you can touch the water. You want to touch the water? Did you get wet this morning? Did you? Okay, come on. Did you? Do you want to touch the water? You can reach in. Can you reach it? Go ahead. Oh, you're trying here. I'll move this out of the way. Get my sleeve all wet. Go ahead. Can you reach up there, Addie? You want to see? Go ahead and put your water in. No? Okay. Do you need help? Here, I'll help you get up. Ready? Oh, there you go. Yeah? Anybody else? Do you need a hand? Okay. Here we go. There you go. So, no. It was pretty fun, though, wasn't it? The water. And what were we doing with all that water splashing around? What were we doing with all the water splashing around? Do you know? Yes, that's part of it, absolutely, but what else? Anybody else's baptism? Us, our baptism. Who here was baptized? Raise your hand. Now, I want you to look around. I'm going to ask that question again. Look all around the sanctuary. Who here was baptized? Everybody, as you look around, was baptized, maybe not at this font, but at a font. And what that does is something amazing. It makes us the body of Christ. And that's the most wonderful thing about baptism, is it connects us together, not just with everybody that we see here in the room, but also with people from different congregations who've been baptized, people who have already been and have already passed away, people from years and years ago, and people that we haven't even met yet, into the future. We're all connected together by this water that is baptism that Jesus asks us to do. Jesus says, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them. So that's something we like to do, is we like to go out and baptize whenever we can. So the baptism is one of those ways that connects us all together. It's a really important day today. And we remember especially Jesus. So let's have a prayer, okay? Dear God, thank you for water and the Word, our baptism, and especially the baptism of our Lord. Help us remember how we are connected to each other in baptism. In Jesus' name, we pray and play and spray water. Amen. All right, off we go.
A reading from Isaiah. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be crushed until he has established justice in the earth and on the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives birth to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord. That is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading is from Acts. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and his household. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? But Jesus answered him, Let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness. Then he consented. And when Jesus had been baptized, just as he came up from the water, suddenly the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord. Be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, I had a great vacation, and while I was on vacation, I came upon this Dairy Queen sign. And the Dairy Queen sign said, Helping you break your New Year's resolutions since 1962. And it's true, right? I mean, it's the 12th of January. And it seems like just a long time ago that we were singing Christmas carols and celebrating Christ's birth. And last week, hearing about the wise men coming and representing Jesus having come to all the world. And we sang Silent Night, and we heard peace on earth, goodwill to all whom God is pleased. And now the reality of the real world come New Year's crashing in, breaking all of our hopes, all of our dreams, and all of our resolutions. We see fires abundant in Australia, killing up to 500,000 animals, ruining people's lives, taking people's lives from them. Puerto Rico suffered earthquakes, devastation, and aftershocks that continue to rumble through that country. We have now, again, a more unsettled Middle East, which always brings anxiety and concern, sending more of our young men and women to put them potentially in harm's way. And then the other stuff that comes crashing in as this new year rolls on, you know, it's time for those test results to come in and the diagnoses to be confirmed. and the surgeries to happen, and all of those things that we've kind of delayed and pushed away because of the holidays are now imminently upon us. So what all seemed so wonderful not long ago now threatens us and raises all kinds of anxiety in our lives. It's maybe why the folks who put together our lectionary put the baptism of our Lord front and center in this first full week of the new year. For it is here in the baptism of our Lord that we are reassured that God is in charge. For this one who was born in Bethlehem and who has grown up so quickly in Nazareth has now come to be baptized and to hear the words, "You are my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And with those words, Jesus is sent on his mission to bring all people the peace and joy and hope that is needed for the new year. It is with this word that you are my beloved Son that in his baptism extends to us in our baptism that we are beloved children of God. And as Pastor Scott mentioned, not only we here, but connected with all the baptized children of God throughout the world, both those who have gone before us and those who will come after us. It is in baptism that God connects us to God's very power to change the world, to reduce our anxiety, to give us hope, and to provide the kind of peace that the world cannot give. It is Jesus who comes and walks through the waters of baptism into our very world and into our very lives as we remember that baptism we ourselves received, so that we might have our anxieties reduced, our fears allayed, and that we might, in confidence and hope, live into the days ahead, knowing that it is God who ultimately is in charge. Martin Luther talks about our life in baptism in this way, that we are like rusty tools, and it is baptism that continues to sharpen us for God's work in the world. And so when we go from this place remembering whose we are, we have the opportunity to let others know that no matter what it looks like for you, no matter whether you're seeing again rifts in your relationships, or whether you're fearful for your young men and women going off to places that puts them in harm's way, or whether those diagnoses that you hear coming at you seem to be life-threatening, that there is a word from God that says, "I am with you." In baptism, we are assured that Jesus walks with us in whatever it is we face, even as he walked all the way to the cross for our sake, and rose again to give us new life. Christ comes again today in water and word, and in bread and in wine, to assure us that no matter what happens, that God is with us. And no matter how bleak things look, Jesus brings light and love and hope. And, oh, by the way, don't forget the blue stones. An opportunity to take that and let somebody know as they're going through a time of struggle or difficulty or anxiety or fear that God is with them and that the community is praying for them. No matter how bad the bad news is, as we enter this 2020 year, the good news of Jesus Christ trumps all of the bad news and reassures us that because Jesus is the beloved Son of God, we also in him are the beloved children of God. And that, folks, is the best news of all. Amen.
Gathered as sisters and brothers in Christ, let us affirm our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Called together through water and the word, we boldly pray for the church, the world, and all who long to hear God's voice. Renewing God, thank you for the gift of baptism. Give your church boldness to proclaim your promises. Tear down obstacles of injustice so that your word of hope reaches the end of the earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we rejoice in the glory of your creation, the beauty of rivers and streams, glaciers and oceans, lakes and ponds. Bring restoration to your earth and free us from overuse and abuse of water, air, and land. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of peace, we give thanks for order in the midst of chaos, though we long for greater justice in our world. Raise up wise and compassionate servant leaders so that all experience your reign of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, thank you for the powerful healing we witness through doctors and nurses, medication, therapy, and holistic means. Break through clouds of pain and anguish with your voice of comfort. Proclaim hope to all who grieve and send healing to all who are sick, especially Gert, Gary, Bob, Steve, Diana, Marjorie, Dale and Connie, Ted, Brianna, John and Sally, Jean, Roberta, Julie, Marlon, Jeff, Isla, Ron, Emily, Denise. We also pray for the families and friends of our Savior's Lutheran Church, Phyllis, Jennifer, Mike, Kelly, Patty, Jasmine, Gerlin, Gil, Bruce, Elijah, Ava, Devald. Pray to comfort the families of Chris Gustafson, sister-in-law of Dale and Connie Gustafson, and Roger Staven, father of Maureen and Steve Shukis. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of courage, we rejoice in this community of hope. Strengthen all who are preparing for baptism and renew the faith of sponsors, mentors, parents, grandparents, friends, and all who guide the newly baptized in this life of joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of love, shower our call committee with your grace and peace and guide the discernment of our candidates who are seeking new opportunities for ministry. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of hope, unleash your spirit to increase our trust in you. We give thanks for the lives of the saints, especially Chris and Roger, who inspire us with lives of baptismal witness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We place our prayers before you, God, united in your spirit, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's take a moment to share that peace.
Let us pray. God of wonder, you formed us in our mother's womb, and from Mother Earth you bring forth this bread and wine. We place them on your table, together with our lives and all that you have made. Open the heavens to us and pour out your spirit. We wait for your mercy. We long for your peace. We hunger and thirst for Jesus Christ, our banquet of life. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, he was shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaimed him your beloved Son. And in the miracle of water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy One, the beginning, the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people, and blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is God.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again. With this bread and cup, we remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. We remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All praise and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. Deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. A quick note about communion here at Our Savior's. You'll receive the wafer in your hand. Hold on to that. And when you come to a cup, there's two compartments. One that has lighter liquid in it, and not for lighters. So, although it will catch a fire. So it's light liquid that is grape juice and darker liquid that is wine. So you simply dip the wafer into one of those two, and then we take the wine and the wafer together. We call that intinction here, and we also want you to know that we honor your family's pattern for taking communion here in this place. But the table is set and all are welcome, so please be seated.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Faithful God, you have kept your promise to us in this meal, nourishing us with the gift of salvation. Now send your servants forth in peace, that we may testify to your goodness and share the hope that is ours. In Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Amen. May Christ, the wisdom and power of God and the source of our life together, keep you united in mind and purpose. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you always. Amen. Amen. We sing together hymn number 459 in your hymnal. 459.
Go in peace to grow, share, love, and inspire.